Hello guys and welcome to Python Programming Tutorials by Amul's Academy. Today in this tutorial we are discussing about a pattern program, that is we want to print stars in the heart shape, that is in this shape. This pattern may look complex but it is very easy. If we combine three patterns we'll get this pattern, okay. So first what I'll do is I'll divide this pattern, next we will write the program for each part, okay, that will be easier. So here we can see I divided the pattern into three parts. So this will be first part, the area which are covered with the yellow color. Next this is the second part and this is the third part, okay. So if you look at the first pattern, this is the pyramid star pattern, right? We already made a video on this. I will give you the link in the description box. So now to print the stars in this shape, we need two for loop because we want to print stars in row as well as column. And here we will use nested for loop, that is for loop within the for loop. So now if I check here, this is the 0th row, 1st row, 2nd row, 3rd row. Okay. So I want this pattern for 4 rows. Okay. So first we'll write the code for this. So in the Python file, first I'll take first for loop. So here I is a variable, you can take any variable. Here range function will tell you how many times this for loop need to be executed, okay. As I said, we need 4 rows, so this for loop need to be executed 4 times because this for loop is to print stars in the rows, okay. So done with this. So inside this I'll take another for loop, that is for column, okay. So now if I look at the pattern, here we can see in some places I want to print space also, like in the beginning here we can see space 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 and we want star, after that we want star, right? So for that what I'll do is I'll take two for loop. One for loop is to print space, okay. Second for loop is to print stars, okay. So first I'll take for loop for space because here we can see first space, right? Before star we want to print space. So here what I'll do is I'll take another for loop called, okay, so how many space I want to print. So here I'll write 4 minus I minus 1. So this is the formula. So we can see in the first row, okay, 0th row, here I value is nothing but row value, okay. When I is equal to 0, here we can see we want 3 space, okay. So if I apply this formula, that is 4 minus I minus 1. So 4 is number of rows here, I is the row value and minus 1. So 4 minus 0 minus 1 will get 3, okay. So we want 3 space, we'll get that from that formula. If I apply that to second row, that is row 1. So when I is equal to 1, 4 minus 1 minus 1, 2 space. So here we'll get 2 space. Here we'll get 1 space. Okay. So this formula will work for this. So here I took that. So I want this many space. Right. So here I want space. So I'll use print function and I'll print space. Done. Next, in the print function by default, end value will be slash n. That's nothing but after printing a message, the control will automatically go to the next line. But here I don't want that. Actually here we can see when I print space, after that I want to print star, okay. I don't want this star in the next line, I want it after the space, okay. So for that I need to keep the control in the same line. So here I'll use end function and I'll take it as empty string. So that's nothing but I don't want new line, keep the control in the same line, okay. So done with the space, now we want to print stars. So now how many stars I want? In the first row I want 1 star, that is when I value equal to 0, that is row value, I want 1 star. When I value is equal to 1, I want 2 star, and I value equal to 2, I want 3 star. When I value equal to 4, I want, I value equal to 3, I want 4 star, right? So that is nothing but I want I plus 1 star, okay. So here I'll write another for loop to print stars. Here I'll take I plus 1, because if row is 0, I want 1 star. If row is 1, I want 2 star. That's why. Here I'll print star. So after that, I'll print a space. Okay, after printing star, print a space. That's nothing but, here we can see, after printing this star, there is a space and next star, right? I want this space. Okay, that's why in the print, what I did, I took a space here. All right. So next, again, I'll take end as empty string. That's nothing but I want to keep the control in the same line. That is while printing this star. Okay, after printing this star, we'll print this space. Then to print next star, I want to keep the control in the same line, right? So that's why here end is equal to empty string. Okay, so next here I'll take print function. This is for new line. Here end is equal to slash n, so control will go to the next line. This is because after done with one row, okay, so I'll print this 3 space and star. Okay, so it will print this space also, because after star there is a space in the print, so it will print star and space. After that, okay, I need to go to the next line, right? For row 1, for row 2 I need to go to the next line, row 3 I need to go to the next line. So after each row I need to go to the next line. That's why here I use this print function, okay, inside the first for loop. This for loop is for rows. That's why after printing space and star in a row, we need a new line. That's why I use this print function. Okay, if I save this and run this, here we can see we got the first part. So done with this part. Now here we can see in the second part, if you want second part, here we can see we want same pattern, right? We want to print stars in the same way. So in the program, what I'll do is I'll copy this, because I want to print same number of space and same number of stars, right? So I'll copy this and I'll place this. So if you ask why I copied here, not after the print means, here we can see. So we want this stars in the single line, right? I want these two pattern next to next, right? So that's why I wrote this here. Now if I run and see what will happen, so we'll get output like this. That is because here we can see in the first case, if here 3 space are needed, here we need 6 space, 1 2 3 4 5 and 6. Okay, this space is already printed because we took print as star and space, right? That's why when it will print this star, it will print this space also. But for these spaces, here we need 6 space. Here if we need 2 space, here we need 4 space. Okay, for the second pattern we need double spaces. Okay, whatever we got in the first pattern, so in the second for loop I need to take double spaces. So what I'll do is 2 multiply. So now if I run and see, okay, so we are getting the proper output. So we are done with the first part and second part. Okay, so now we need to concentrate on the last part. So next we want to print this pattern, that is part 3. Okay, so here we can see this is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So I want total 8 rows. Okay, and I want to print stars in rows as well as column, right? So what I'll do is I'll take 2 for loop for this. So outer for loop is for row, I'll take 8 because number of rows is 8 there. So here I'll take for j in range. So here also we can see this is the same pattern, but it is inverse, right? So here we can see we want to print space as well as we want to print stars. First we'll write the for loop for to print space. Okay, so how many space we want to print? First I don't want any space. Next I want 1 space, 2 space, 3 space, 4 space, 5 6 7. Okay, so for this what I'll do is here in the main for loop I'll change the start and end value in the range function. So here I'll take like this 8, 0, minus 1. So first I value will be 8. So that's nothing but here first the row value will be 8. Okay. So I value will be 8. So it will print 8 stars and 0 space. So now here I don't want any space. That's why here I'll take 8 minus I. Okay. Because initially I value will be 8. So 8 minus I means 8 minus 8, 0. So it won't print any space. So here. Okay. So when I value becomes 7, next it will become 7. Okay. Because step is minus 1. So 8 minus 7. So 1. So it will print 1 space. Here we'll get that. Next 8 minus 6. So we'll get 2 space. 8 minus 5, we'll get 3 space. Okay, in that way we'll get the proper space. Next for loop is to print stars. So how many stars I want? When I value is 8, I want 8 star. When I value 7, I want 7 star. Okay, so here I'll take I. Okay, 0 minus 1 and print star space and end equal to empty string. Okay, so next here I'll take print. So these both the pattern are same, but here it is inversed. Okay, that's why I took range in the reverse order. That's it. Okay, so if I run this now, okay, here we can see the stars in the heart shape. Okay, so here we wrote this program for a particular input, right? So here we took 4 rows, 8 rows. But if I want to make it general program, if I want to take the input from the user, then how to do that? So for that, what I can do is, so here how we'll take the input is, we'll ask the user to enter the number of columns. Okay, actually, so that's nothing but here we can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so we'll print star in the print function. We'll print like this star and space. Okay, so it, if we count this as 1, so it will print this ones. Okay, so there are 8 number of columns. So we'll ask the user to enter the number of columns, okay, in the input. So here what I'll do is, I'll take one num int input enter the number. So here, so this is the code to print maximum 8 stars in a row. Okay, so that is the number of column. Okay, I need to keep that this part of code is written for num is equal to 8. So wherever I'll get 8, I will change that to num. Okay, for example, here we can see 8, so I'll change that to num. Here also 8, so num. Alright, so this is done. So next here we can see 4. What is 4? It is the half of 8, right? So here I'll take variable called n and num truncated division 2. So this truncated division only give the integer value. Okay, so now instead of 4, I'll take it as n. Okay, so done. Here 2 is same because we want double space, that's why. Okay, so now I'll save this and run this. So first I'll enter 8 and I'll check. Okay, so we'll get output. Okay, so next I'll enter 6. Okay, an even number, we'll get the output. Again I'll enter 12. Okay, I will get the output. So till now we checked for only even numbers. Now I'll check for the odd number, whether it will work for the odd number or not. Okay, so run. So I'll take 9. Okay, so it won't print proper output. Here we can see we'll get an extra star here. Okay, so this part. So now what I need to do, I need to fix up. So this program will work for the even number, but it won't work for the odd numbers. So for that, what I need to do is, so I need to do a simple change here in this space where we are printing this space. So here I'll take one condition, okay. If num modulus 2, that is nothing but if enter the input is even, then it will work. So cut and paste that here. Okay, so else if the entered input is odd, okay, so now what I need to do is copy. Okay, so here I'll add plus 1. Okay, I want an extra space. Now I'll check whether it will work or not. Okay, so I'll enter 9. Okay, so here we can see it will give proper output, right? So we'll get the heart shape. Okay, so for odd numbers here I need to add plus 1. I need one extra space. Okay, so if I add about 15, yes, it will print. So now if I check for 10, okay, yes, it will work. Okay, so in this way we can print the stars in the heart shape. So now if you want to print any message in the center of the heart, then you need to watch the next tutorial. Okay, so that's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.